Hi, so this video is about showing you my project for the Redis Conf 2021 hackathon. It's my game called Pizza Tribes. I will show you the game real quick here. It's a game about managing your population of mice, and they want to bake pizza and sell pizza to gain coins. The player with the most coins is the winner and ends up the top one slot in the leaderboards. So you can build different buildings. You can train mice to different roles. They will work in different buildings and produce pizza. You also have a map view where you can see other players. You can click those to send thieves to other towns to steal their coins. We have the stats view that shows a bit of stats, how your production is going, and also a view here, a diagram showing you the pizzas and coins over time in your town. Yeah, so this is built using Redis. Redis is, as you can see in this picture, in the heart of it. I've shown you the web app. The web app communicates with a lot of web sockets with the web server. The web server will push those messages to a Redis list, and a worker will pick up that message and process it, update the game state, and maybe push back a message to another Redis list that the web server can pull from and send back to the web app. I also have the updater process that will update game state, for example, when a building has been completed. It will update the game state and it will push a WebSocket message back to the web app. So I've explained short here the WebSocket communication with the rpush blpop on lists, and I will show you right now the game state, how it's stored. I use RedisJSON to store the game state for each player here with a key. So it keeps more or less all the game state for that player. I also have a sorted set that the updater process will use. So user updates. So the updater essentially work like this: pulls the top record in that list that's set. And it can take a look at the score, which is a time, and if that time has passed, then it's time to update that game state, and it will update the game state, update the time, so that it will start processing the next game state and the next game state after that. So that's how the updater works. This view here, the resource history view, is built using RedisTimeSeries. So every time the coins or pizzas change, we'll store a data point. So this view was actually very easy to build with RedisTimeSeries. There are a couple of other functions and inner workings. Have world zones, so the map is split up into zones. Redis keeps track of the open zones in which players can still register. Don't want too many players in the same zone. Yeah, there are probably more functions, but no time for that right now. I hope the documentation will answer more questions. Thanks.